So in the next portion, you're talking about linear systems of equations. We're going to talk about the number of solutions of a linear system. And we'll find there's three possibilities, that we have one solution, no solutions, or an infinite number. Let's start with a linear system we've got here, 2x plus y equal to 3, and 6x minus 3y equal to 15. Let's solve this using the algebraic method of addition or subtraction that we saw in the last video. So in order to do that, I'm going to take, let's use my first equation here. I'm going to multiply it by 3 in order that I can get the coefficients of the x to be the same. So I'm going to multiply this whole equation by 3. I'm going to get 6x plus 3y equal to 9. And the bottom equation, I'm staying the same, 6x minus 3y equal to 15. And actually what this has done is we've got our positive 6x here on both these. So if we subtract these equations, 6x minus 6x, we get 0. 3y minus negative 3y gives me 6y equal to 9 minus 15, negative 6. Divide both sides by 6, and we get that our y is negative 1. That worked out pretty well. It gave us our y value. Let's go back to these equations, though. I'm not even going to have to do a second multiplication, because if we look at these two equations, the y values are opposites to each other. So if we add the two equations, we'll find that the y's will add to 0, and we'll be left with some x's that we can work with. So let's go down here, same two equations we just had. This time, instead of subtracting, like I did up here, I'm going to add the equations together. 6x plus 6x gives me 12x, 3y plus negative 3y gives me 0, 9 plus 15 gives me 24, divide both sides by 12, and I got that x is equal to 2. So there's the solution for those two equations. Now, this x and y, as we've seen before, gives us the coordinates of a single point, 2, negative 1, being our final solution here. If we take these two equations, we can graph them. Let's do that now. So let's take 2x plus y equal to 3. I'm going to rearrange this, solve it for y, and that one's going to turn into y is equal to negative 2x plus 3. We can graph that. Y-intercept of 3, slope of negative 2, down 2 over 1. We can graph that line. There's our first one. And our second equation, 6x minus 3y equal to 15. Solve this for y. We're going to move the 6x over. Negative 3y is equal to negative 6x plus 15. Divide everything by negative 3. We'll get y is equal to 2x minus 5. We'll graph that line. Start down at our y-intercept of negative 5. Slope of 2. Up 2 and over 1. And we can see there that that point is our intersection, our solution, 2, negative 1. Just like we found doing this in algebraic method. Now, let's look at a case where the algebra doesn't work out quite so nicely. Let's try, how about this one here, 3x plus y equal to 9, and 6x plus 2y equal to 6. We try and solve this one algebraically. Let's see what happens. Let's start by trying to eliminate the x's. So I'm going to multiply this equation by 2. So I can get 6x and 6x here. That's going to give me 6x plus 2y equal to 18. The bottom equation I can change. 6x plus 2y equal to 6. Subtract both equations. Subtract one from another, sorry. 6x minus 6x gives me 0. 2y minus 2y also gives me 0. 18 minus 6 gives me 12. What I've ended up with here is an equation that says 0 equals 12. Obviously it doesn't. That doesn't work. So if we end up with this situation, we say then that there is no solution. Doing an algebraic, we see that there's no solution because we can't have 0 equals 12. Well, let's see what these equations look like if we were to graph them. We started with 3x plus y equal to 9. If we solve that for y, we get y is equal to negative 3x plus 9. Let's graph that guy. Y-intercept of 9, slope of negative 3. Graph that. And our second equation was 6x plus 2y equal to 6. We solve that for y. We're going to get negative 3x. What would that be? Plus 2, I believe. Plus 3, sorry. Negative 3x plus 3. Let's graph that line. Starts here at 3, slope of negative 3. What we can see is that when we graph these lines, representing it visually, these lines are parallel. They'll never intersect, so there is no solution. There can be no solution because the solution is the coordinates of the point where they intersect. If they don't intersect, no solution. How can we recognize this? Looking at just the left-hand side of this equation, this left-hand side, one equation is a multiple of the other. If you multiply 3x by 2, we get 6x. If you multiply y by 2, we get 2y. So that side is a multiple of each other. The 9 and the 6 are not. If we multiplied 9 by 2, we would not get 6. Okay? So they're not a multiple of each other. Just one side is. That's why the whole side added up to 0 when we tried to solve this. That's the other possibility. If we have parallel lines, there is no solution. And the last possibility, if we were to do this algebraically here, 6x plus 2y equal to 18, and 3x plus y equal to 9. So I was reading in the wrong order there. So let's try and eliminate the 6's here again, or the x's. We can see that we start off with the same thing here, 3x plus y, 6x plus 2y, but our numbers are slightly different here. Now we have 9 and 18. Let's multiply this by 2. We get 6x plus 2y equal to 18, and we see that that is identical to our bottom equation. Now if we subtract those, 6x and 6x is 0, 2y and 2y is 0, 18 minus 18 is 0, we get 0 equals 0. This is a true statement, so there is a solution, but we can't find out what that solution is. And the reason being, if we're going to graph these here in a sec, we're going to find that these two lines are actually the same line, and that there are actually infinite solutions, because these two things are the same line. To graph them. Actually, we don't even need to bother graphing. We can just look at these equations here. If we take this first one, 3x plus y equal to 9. We solve that. Y equal to negative 3x plus 9. Bring that guy down there. If we take 6x plus 2y equal to 18, solve that for y. Move the 6x's over, divide everything by 2. We also get y equal to negative 3x plus 9. I'm not going to go through the algebra of that. You can prove that for yourself. Those two lines are going to end up being the same. They're going to intersect at every single point on those lines, so there are infinite number of solutions. Those are the three possibilities for the solutions of a linear system of equations.